And my name is Ina.
And I'm Holly.
And I'm Natalie.
And we are the Orange County's finest wedding planning company. And these are our business cards. And our company is Excellence in Motion. With over 20 years of experience, we are here to turn your dream into an elegant reality. We pride ourselves in planning and preparing extraordinary memories in iconic world-renowned locations across the luxury Orange County. And our target audience are from Newport Beach, and they're classy, also their trendy style, they're at the high society, and they're willing to spend for the look that they want. And our coming event will be in spring 2018, March to May. And the location will be Harborside, the Grand Ballroom in Newport Beach. Our theme color will be blush, mint, and ivory. And the estimated guests will be 250 people. And the size of the bridal party will be 6 bridesmaids and 6 groomsmen. And we'll have 2 packages and 1 additional add-on. So Natalie will talk about this for us.
Okay, so we have 2 packages and then 1 with extra amenities that you can add on to any package you like. So our basic package has pre-wedding planning, day of planning, 2 meetings, an organized rehearsal. We're going to start 1 year out. A personal timeline, 2 options for glassware and silverware. A bride and groom interview at the first meeting, 6 hours day of service, a visit to the venue, and then we can discuss your decorations and your theme. So for Friday and Saturday, our price is $9,000, and then if you book Sunday through Thursday, it's a little bit cheaper, it's going to be $75. So then our deluxe package is a lot of the same as our basic. Instead of 2 meetings, you're going to get about 3 to 4, unlimited emails, calls, texts, whatever. We're also going to have an e-invites option if they would like. We're going to create a website for the wedding. We're going to begin 15 months instead of a year, so we're going to give them a few extra months to book those vendors. they're going to have every option available for glassware and silverware, unlimited options. And then we're also going to give them a questionnaire and an interview at their first meeting just to get to know them a lot better. Do their lighting, their sound, and their technology. And then same thing, 6 hours day of service, a visit to the venue, and then decor and theme. A little bit more expensive, so Friday, Saturday is $12,000, and Sunday through Thursday will be $10,000. And then we have a lot of extra amenities that you can add to any package you choose. Place setting rentals, food tasting appointments, a photography package, cake and dessert, makeup and hair, a champagne toast at the reception. For each hour that you go over, it's $500. And floral design, arrangements, bouquets, and then we're even gonna help with the honeymoon planning.
And then this is included in the extra amenities. There's options for bridal hairstyles, and we have lookbooks of different options and styles for the unique bridal, for their theme and their kind of feel that they want to do. We'll have a lookbook of the different options that they can choose from. And then for the ceremony, we're going to go through and just list all the different aspects of it and how they all coordinate along with the theme. The theme is going to continue with blush, mint, and ivory as the theme colors. And yes, we have a little.
Yeah, I found this little thing. So this will be our tablecloth color. This is napkin color. Pretend that those white napkins are this color.
But yes, the ceremony, the focal point that we're going to go for is the altar area where the bride and groom are going to be standing in the front. And you obviously want that to be like the center of attention. You want it to be focused on them and enhancing their whole experience when they're out there. So we'll have a lot of flowers and then some drapery going over, but kind of just mellow colors like the blush and the ivory and champagne colors, so it doesn't take away from the couple. We'll do flowers up the aisle, kind of drawing your attention up towards the front where they are. And then we'll move to the cocktail reception after the ceremony is over. And and continuing the color theme to that. The focal point for this is going to be something a little bit different. It's going to be a photo memory table. Since it's kind of a social atmosphere with the cocktail reception, it's something that the guests can just kind of wander around and look at as they're socializing. It'll have pictures of their relationship, pictures of them and their families, or as children, and just have all these different little mementos and things that really highlight what makes the couple so unique. And then there will also be tray passed hors d'oeuvres and the bar there. The signature drink is going to be a cherry blossom martini, and it'll go along with the whole cherry blossom theme. And there's an example of what the couple's memory table could look like. And then moving on to the dinner reception, the colors will continue through, and we have an example here of what we're going to do for the sweetheart table, because that's going to be our highlight or the center focal point of the dinner reception. We really want to like seclude and highlight that table and individual. So one thing that we're going to do is put underlights under the table, that just the couple's table, to kind of make it glow and stand out from all the rest of them in the room. And then here we don't have the flowers, but make a tall centerpiece on their table with floral decorations, and just really highlight that table and give it like a whimsical, beautiful look. And then we'll continue with the dinner reception, and there will be, the dessert will also be at this location, and also there will be a dance floor and a DJ for the later night entertainment. But just during the dinner reception, there will be a violinist and pianist just to keep it really mellow and elegant.
Okay. Our menu. During the cocktail hour, we're going to have a tray pass of hors d'oeuvres. The hors d'oeuvres are going to be a brie and pear phyllo, a beef wellington with a horseradish sauce, chicken empanadas with guacamole, and a seared ahi crostini. So the brie and pear is kind of the vegetarian, then you've got a beef, a chicken, and fish. For the salad, it's going to be a strawberry spinach toss with a bruschetta cheese toast, just something light. At weddings, they're eating literally all day, and can't make everything super full, like heavy, they're not going to be able to eat everything. And so for the entree, we have a duet. We have a macadamia mahi-mahi with a mango salsa, a petit filet with a cognac sauce, a basil risotto, and then just a vegetable, medley of vegetables.
And so this is like what we're explaining with the sweetheart table, that it's really just the most exciting part of the whole dinner reception location. And then the wedding cake, this is probably like the secondary focal point at the dinner reception. It'll be more towards the side, so it doesn't take away from the whole atmosphere, but then there will be a time where they have a toast and the bridesmaids and groomsmen will say a few words, and then the cake cutting, and then that'll lead into the later night DJ time.
So as well as the cake, we're also going to have like a dessert station with different kinds of desserts. We're going to have like little mousse cup shot glasses, chocolate covered strawberries, and fruit tartlets to keep a wide variety of everything. Not everybody likes cake.
And for the program, the guests will arrive at 4 o'clock, and from 5 to 5:30 we'll have the ceremony. And starting from 6 o'clock, we'll have the cocktail hour, and then we'll have the toast at from 6:45. And the salads will be served from 7 o'clock, and the entry will be served from 7:30. And we will start the slideshow from 8 p.m. And the garden toast will be at 8:30. And we'll have the open dancing at 9 o'clock, and the cake cutting at 9:30. After that, we'll have the DJ playing the music for the guests, and the event will be end at 11 o'clock.